Hi, I'm MLive Chief Meteorologist Mark Torregrossa. It is said there are no two snowflakes exactly the same. That thought may be true. No two snowflakes take the same path down to Earth. The temperature and humidity conditions on a snowflake's journey to the ground dictate what the snowflake eventually will look like. There have been 35 basic forms of snowflakes identified. These 35 snowflakes are divided into a few groups. Snowflake size and shape is dictated by the temperature and humidity level where the snowflake is born. Most snowflakes develop in the mid-level of the atmosphere around 10,000 to 15,000 feet up in the air. The classic snowflake is called a dendrite. It's the biggest, most symmetrical snowflake. Dendrites form at a temperature around 5 degrees Fahrenheit with high humidity. As the temperature where the snowflake is born is warmer or colder, the size of the snowflake goes down and the shape changes. With the same temperature around 5 degrees Fahrenheit but lower humidity, dendrites turn into plate snowflakes. At a warmer temperature of 15 to 25 degrees Fahrenheit, the snowflakes become columns. At very cold temperatures aloft of 5 degrees below or colder, we get a combination of columns and plates. These flakes tend to be small regardless of the shape. At very cold temperatures, it takes a long time for small-sized columns and plates to pile up. The biggest snowflakes are usually a conglomeration of several snowflakes. This often occurs when temperatures near the ground are close to freezing. As the snowflakes fall and become sticky, they combine to make a hunk of snowflakes. When the snowflakes start to fall, make sure to stay updated with winter weather coverage on MLive.com. And join me every morning on Facebook Live. I can answer your winter travel weather questions.